is one of the artists here at Foundation for Hospital Art.
Hi, Miss
Barbara.
Hi.
So you know what? One of the things we think is so cool is the impact that your program has. So I wonder if you could speak a little bit about that.
Well, it's so fun to be here. And yeah, the Foundation for Hospital Art is a nonprofit organization. We're based out of Atlanta, Georgia, but we go all over the world, all over the U.S., because we believe that no matter where you live, art can help comfort and love people. And so we have made it our mission to go all over the world and to put our quest, our vision, is to put a mural in every hospital or clinic on earth. And so we're in 195 countries and counting.
Wow.
And over 1 million people have helped us paint. And we go everywhere. We just bring our canvases and our paint and our brushes, and we paint with everybody, because painting, just like singing and different parts of creativity, are a way to unite us. So it's a beautiful way to send love to one another. Very easy to do.
So this is a unique session today.
Yes.
And why do you feel that this particular project is important?
Well, we're getting to paint a very special mural today that was created for the state of Georgia and for the Republic of Georgia, our sister city. And so we're so happy that we can show a little love to our fellow man across the sea.
Yes.
And so it's very special to be able to unite and to know that they too are going to be enjoying what we're doing. It's very special for us. Art can unite us. There's more things that bind us together than tear us apart. And art and doing this mural is one of them. So we're so happy to be able to paint this for our friends in the Republic of Georgia.
So why don't you share with the rest of the Guard family your name and your role in this project?
So my name's Kaylin, and we're making a mural painting for the country of Georgia.
Yeah.
And we live in the state of Georgia.
Yes.
And we're going to make this for them.
Yeah.
And because this is, it's got some of their state.
Yep.
Their state things, and some of our state crops and state symbols.
Cool. And so you know that it's Month of the Military Child, right, Kaylin?
Yes, sir.
So why do you think that Month of the Military Child is so important?
Because it recognizes what the children of the military kids and what they go through when they're grandchildren.
Excellent, excellent. If you had one question, one thing you'd want to learn about kids in the Republic of Georgia, what would that be?
What they do for fun.
Cool. Thank you so much, Kaylin. Okay, so we have Sarah, who is one of our coolest state youth council members. Good morning, Sarah.
Mr. Mark.
Hey, so listen, if you could ask a kid over in the Republic of Georgia any question, what would you ask them?
I'd probably ask, what's life like?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Yeah, what is it like over there being a military child?
Well, that's cool. So you know what? Since you would ask that question, I'm going to ask you another question. What is life like for you as a military kid here in the state of Georgia?
It takes just as much responsibility to be a military kid and take care of yourself as, and your, be a part of your family as much as it does to.
That's okay. I'm not
reading. That's good stuff, though. That's good.
Yeah, it takes responsibility because you have to make sure that you you are capable of keeping up with everything and taking care of yourself, taking care of your siblings and your pets if you have them, and making sure that you I guess know what you're doing, because you're not always going to have that second parent or have that other supervisor to help you out.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to, you take on that responsibility.
We have a brother and sister team. Why don't you introduce yourselves, guys?
I'm Maurice.
I'm James.
And what is your role with the Georgia National Guard Youth Program?
I'm the school president currently.
Yeah. And Jalen, how do you feel about being a state youth council member? What is your favorite part?
Do a whole bunch of different activities.
Like, great. And Maurice, if you could ask a question of a kid over in the Republic of Georgia, what would you ask?
Would you want to work together and try and get this kind of organization to get bigger, try to spread it out?
Sweet. So what has been some of your experiences being a military kid? What are some of the challenges you face?
Challenges, definitely, it's a lot of work.
You
have to be very committed in order to do this. It's a lot of, you know, attending meetings, having plans, and showing up with the mindset to work and being ready to put in the effort to do stuff. But it's fulfilling when you get to see the end result of what you've accomplished.
Sweet. So what do you guys hope to get out of, what do you hope to see from this project with children over in the Republic of Georgia? What do you hope to get out of this? What do you think is going to be the biggest takeaway?
Teamwork.
Oh, yeah, I love it. That is a great answer. Introduce yourself, new state youth council member.
My name is Conlon Braun.
How you doing, Conlon?
Still doing well today.
Awesome. So, share your role here today.
I'm painting part of, we're painting a mural for the state of Georgia and the country of Georgia. I'm currently painting part of the country of Georgia and a wolf head.
Sweet. So, April is month of the military child. Why is that important to you?
Because I'm a military child.
Yeah.
And it's important to me because it's a month that we are recognized.
Yeah.
And it's just a good time, I guess.
Yeah, that's good stuff. And we appreciate you and your contributions to the Guard family. So if you could ask, we're doing this project together with kids from the Republic of Georgia. What one thing would you want to know about military kids over in the Republic of Georgia?
Probably their favorite sport.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. What sport they like over there, right? single moms, and you've been doing this for a minute. Your family has a legacy in the State Youth Council. So we just want to ask you, how has being a military kid had an impact on your daughters?
Gosh, that is a fantastic question. And it's opened them up to so many different opportunities and activities that they would never even think about trying. And also it involves them with other kids from different backgrounds and different areas in the state. So they've learned about the coastal region. They've learned about the metropolitan areas. They've learned about the mountainous regions. So they've had various opportunities with different kids and different instructors over all these years.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. So this is a huge project. And I'm sure you know that we have that wonderful relationship with the Republic of Georgia. So what are your thoughts on how this project that we're doing with the kids over in the Republic of Georgia, how do you see that have an impact on their lives as military kids?
Well, you know, the great thing about having this relationship with the other state of Georgia is that our kids will eventually get to have that communication, that bridge of learning about their world and what they go through, which is somewhat, you know, alike, but also very, very different.
Yes.
Because we're in another country. So that gives them an opportunity I don't think they would have other, you know, in their everyday lives.
If you could say one thing to a parent over in the Republic of Georgia, what would you say? A parent of a military child over there. What kind of words of encouragement would you give them?
To participate in activities like this.
Yeah.
Participate in groups that have similar experiences that you're going through. And then also participate in groups that don't, so you get the broader spectrum. But having a military child coming from a family, whether you're a full-time military active duty person or a reservist, you eventually all go through the same channels.
Yeah.
You go through the same experiences, whether it's, you know, a weekend or if it's a daily duty. It's just, your kids are affected. They sometimes internalize it, sometimes they don't. Hold them close, hug them often, give them encouragement, and groups like this help them thrive.